Good evening, class. I said, good evening, class. Hey, Victor. Victor, please sit down, sir. Victor, sit down. Hey, TT. TT, put your phone down. Come on, let's pay attention. Ron, listen up. Let's pay attention. Come on, everybody, let's pay attention. Amari, stop throwing paper at Nicholas. Come on, Amari, let's go. All right, class, now that I got your attention, today's topic, we will be discussing three words: relinquish, replenish, and restore, with a little twist from the story of Jonah. Can I get two individuals to help me with something? Two individuals? Jeremiah? Can you guys help me? Men who believe? Can you help me, please? Get up and demonstrate this to the congregation.
There have always been hunters going after whales. And they've been going after whales since the 11th century because the whales have two things that hunters always want. Whales, hear this, have oil. And whales have an abundance of flesh. You have to be careful because there are only two things the enemy wants from you. The enemy wants your oil, and the enemy wants your flesh. There are so many principalities in the earth that are targeting you that when they cannot get to your oil, they will settle for trying to get to your flesh. There are people who you actually think were attracted to you. It is not your oil. It is not your aura. It is your oil they want. And if they can't get your oil, they'll settle with getting your flesh. There are many people who are intimidated by your oil, and so they think that the only thing they can get access to is your flesh. Y'all still are not awakened here today. And the enemy needs to know today that he will not have access to either, because there is such a price that comes with the oil that is oozing out of my life. And you are on high alert all the time, and folk don't understand why you are resistant and gotta have walls up. Because in church there are people that want your oil, and after the benediction there are people that want your flesh. So you gotta fight off people in either direction, and you don't know who to trust. You don't know what they really after. You don't know what their game plan is, and folk think that you are stuck up and stand off. Because people want their oil or they want their flesh. Jonah, the reprobate, disobedient prophet who went in an opposite direction, he buys a ticket to get on the merchant sea ship. You always got to be mindful of something, that he gets on this ship and thinks that he has outrun God. A tsunami surrounds the ship. The sailors figure out who is the culprit responsible for their predicament. And they reconcile that the best way to resolve the turbulence is to throw Jonah overboard. I gotta show you something, I don't want you to miss it. They throw Jonah overboard. They get rid of Jonah. They leave Jonah to die. I need you to hear, I cannot afford for you to miss this. None of the sailors who threw him overboard are anointed. None of those who threw him overboard have an assignment. And I'm trying to figure out how it is I carry the glory of God and I got hurt by somebody that carries nothing. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
And you're